This WBTV High Definition program is sponsored by Time Warner Cable. WBTV News Prime Time starts right now.
Now on Primetime, the return of the Charlotte Hornets. For years, one of the most popular teams in the NBA, yanked away from us 8 years ago. The new team, the Bobcats, struggling to put points on the board, struggling to put fans in the seats. We've got the old coach back. Now we just need our old name back.
I'm Steve Krupp at Time Warner Cable Arena in Center City, Charlotte. Hundreds turning out in the middle of the day. And 20 years later, it's still all about the shoes.
But the winter weather alert is first on Primetime. Let the brining begin. Because if our Christmas is going to be white, our streets are going to be safe. Hello, thanks for being here tonight. I'm Jamie Bull, in for Maureen Boyle. State and local DOT crews are staying ahead of the weather, ready to pre-treat our roads and highways. WBTV's Tom Rousey live in Charlotte. And it's 7 o'clock, Tom. The brining begins, right?
Yeah, we just saw about a half dozen trucks leave, and we just had another one pull up behind me here that's going to get ready to go out. This is just one of two NCDOT stations here in Mecklenburg County where the trucks are hitting the roads from tonight. They're going to be out till 5 a.m., and this is just the beginning. They plan to pre-treat roads throughout the day on Friday, trying to make sure that that stuff, when it falls, doesn't freeze right away on Christmas Day. Charlotte Department of Transportation has also been out already today pre-treating things like bridges, which always freeze first. So the trucks are hitting the road. They've hit them already today with the city. Now the state is hitting the road tonight and into the early morning hours tomorrow. And then even beyond that, if necessary, they're going to be hitting the roads, pre-treating it with a salt brine solution. The whole point of that stuff is to try to make it so when the frozen stuff hits the pavement, it doesn't freeze right away. But if it gets cold enough, it will still freeze. So they know they might have to have crews out on Christmas Day. I'm told up to 90 trucks could be out just in the region of the DOT that handles Charlotte and Mecklenburg County alone. Also, the city planning to have 80 employees, they say, up to 80 employees coming in for Christmas if it is necessary. And I know a lot of the workers here are hoping it is not necessary, but it certainly has sounded like we're going to get some snow. Yeah. Live tonight in Northwest Charlotte, I'm Tom Rousey, WBTV News Primetime.
Yeah, messing up a lot of family plans, unfortunately. Tom, thank you. And for weather coverage 24/7, we want you to visit WBTV.com. Your full forecast, school closings, delays, and anytime you see weather in your neighborhood, you can send us pictures. All right, well, let's get the very latest on the forecast now. Chief Meteorologist Eric Thomas been watching this system all week long, inching ever closer to us. What's the latest here?
So it looks like we're just going to get a swipe out of it, Jamie. But nonetheless, that is still enough to create a stir around here. And along with it, the timing is obviously auspicious. Is that the right word?
Sure.
Yeah, okay, good. I was hoping. I was reaching for that one. All right, well, here's the story. We've got this snow right now on the mountain. And a lot of that actually has been natural snow. It's been busy up there across the Carolina High Country with winter weather. And the skiers are loving it. 22 degrees. The question is the landscape going to look like this around the Charlotte area over the weekend? Well, let's get you, first of all, caught up on where things stand. Yes, there is a bit more moisture working its way across the middle of the country right now. And that, along with the colder air working its way down back into the Carolinas, that's going to be the combination that we need to at least give ourselves a chance to get some snowfall around here. And again, that timing, Christmas Day, a lot of people would really enjoy that, especially the kids opening their presents and having a chance to maybe play in it just a little bit. Meanwhile, we'll take you down this evening with no disruptions to 32 by about 9 o'clock, 30 by 11. Again, we'll talk about accumulations, what we're expecting, and your first alert forecast over your Christmas holiday coming up shortly.
All right, Eric, we'll see in a few minutes. A teenage murder suspect is in custody after he allegedly led police on a high-speed chase down I-85. Here's the aftermath. The 17-year-old driver allegedly killed a teenage girl yesterday at an East Charlotte apartment complex. The victim's name, Shofa Johnson. The suspect here, Trey Cortez Barber. He had a female friend with him at the time of the crash. They're both in the hospital tonight, taken there by ambulance after crashing their car. Once they're released from the hospital, they'll be taken to police headquarters for questioning. And not the first time Trey Barber has allegedly led cops on a chase. This video here from August, high-speed chase, major street, middle of the day. Barber and another guy allegedly led police on a chase after a burglary in University City. The five-mile road chase ended when the duo allegedly clipped a truck and took off on foot through a graveyard. Familiar face on the bench for the Charlotte Bobcats. Paul Silas is the new interim head coach. Remember, he was the old Hornets coach from 99 to 02. He's taking over for Larry Brown. Owner Michael Jordan showed Brown the door yesterday. All season long, he'd taken shots at the players and at himself. Didn't really seem to want to be here. But Paul Silas does. He led the Hornets to the playoffs in each of his four full seasons and was very popular here in our community. Then there's the new Hornets, the New Orleans Hornets. Owner George Shinn took the team there in 2002 after a sex scandal made him a social pariah in Charlotte. 2 years later, the Bobcats arrived in the Queen City, and now both teams are dysfunctional at best. The Hornets are looking for a new owner. The Bobcats are looking for wins and fans. So why not a compromise? While there's no way we're going to get back LJ, Zoe, and Muggsy back on the court, maybe, just maybe, we can get the teal and purple back in Charlotte. In primetime's Jeff Atkinson joining us now. Jeff, Charlotte Hornets, could it be again?
There's a possibility, Jamie. The NBA officially took over the Hornets, the New Orleans Hornets franchise this week, buying it from George Shinn. And now, should the Hornets' name become a free agent, some think owner Michael Jordan should bring it here. It's our cover story tonight. Hornets was more than a name to us. It was a salute to our past. A British commander during Revolutionary War referred to Charlotte's fierce resistance as a hornet's nest of rebellion. The team won our hearts, though they would win few games. After going 20-62 the first season, the city threw owner George Shinn a parade down Tryon Street. We were in the big leagues. Pearl Shear, the Hornets' first president and GM, remembers that first game they played.
As the clock got to 0-0, and I looked up at the stands, there were 24,000 people on their feet giving the Hornets a standing ovation. And I said to myself, I think we've got something very special.
Which is why when they packed up and left in May of 02, it left such a bad taste in our mouth. And maybe why the city hasn't fallen head over heels for the Bobcats. But bring back the name, like you brought back the old coach, and who knows? Eric Spanberg covers sports in Uptown Charlotte and writes for the Charlotte Business Journal.
People would love to see Hugo the Hornet and the logo and all those things. I think they just stir up warm, fuzzy feelings in general.
But think about all those logos you'd have to change. A makeover estimated to run $4 million. Changing uniforms, colors, and logos. Not to mention losing what's been spent so far to market the team. Of course, some of that could be recouped with fans purchasing new team gear.
I just think bringing the Hornets back would be better for the team.
You'd have to change your shirt.
I can deal with that.
Other fans in line at the arena to buy the new Air Jordan retro shoes are divided.
Yeah, it goes down to history, but just need to let it stay in history.
I think with all the tradition that was here when we built up the original team, I think you still have that fan base here.
I don't think they should change the name back just because I think that era is over now.
Right now, the name's not for sale. The Bobcats are said to be commissioning a market survey to gauge fans' feelings. Bobcats president Fred Whitfield.
If that name does happen to become available, we'll research it, we'll talk to our fans, we'll figure whether we've, gotten enough brand loyalty in the Cats and decide whether we need to just continue to move forward with the brand that we built.
MJ, the new owner, is getting the franchise out more in the community. Changing the name could help distance him from the past, getting rid of some of the feelings associated with the old owner, Bob Johnson, who carried his name. Mm-hmm. We'll have to see how this plays out, Jamie.
But we're not going to build the old Coliseum again.
That part
is long gone. Is there a history of other cities sort of getting their names back?
Not in the NBA. Only one we could think of was in the NFL. Cleveland lost the Browns. Oh, right. The team went to the Baltimore and then became the Ravens. Years later, when the NFL awarded Cleveland an expansion team, they got the Browns' name back.
So. You still see plenty of Hornets gear around town, so mm-hmm. Some folks would still be ready to go if that would indeed happen.
Absolutely.
All right, Jeff, great story. Thanks. So, what do you think? Should they change their name back to the Hornets? You can vote right now in our online poll. Just go to WBTV.com. By the way, the new-look Bobcats will make their debut under Coach Silas at home Monday against Detroit. Coming up next here on Primetime.
This is Morris Blackman, and this is my main man, Michael Jordan. And this is a pair of...
It is the shoes. Nike releases a new Air Jordan retro today. Dozens line up for a shot at taking home a pair.
I'm David Wisnett. From the roads to the tailpipe, I talked to a state trooper today who gave me some very frank and honest answers about how to stay safe if you have to drive in bad weather.
And a bit later on, 16 and pregnant? Not if you watch MTV. How a show about teen pregnancy is preventing teen pregnancy.